Incorporating a gratitude ritual into my daily routine has completely helped me to positively transform my life. Because the beautiful thing about gratitude is the more of it that you find, the more of it that you see. The more times you're grateful for all of the good, amazing things that have happened for you, or even the things that haven't yet happened for you, the more of those things you'll find. There'll literally be days where I'm driving down the road and I'll see something on the side of the road, or I'll see a person, or I'll see the sunset or the mountains and the landscape, and I'll think to myself, I'm so grateful to be alive right now. I'm so grateful to be able to roll the windows down and feel the air against my face and against my skin. And the more I practice gratitude, the more of it that I find and the more joy I experience in my life. And I want to share with you a few different gratitude practices that I've used in my life that I found to work extremely well. And I want you to try them too, because I know it will help you to make improvements in your life. One of my favorite gratitude rituals that I'll practice at least a few times a week is called amplifying the good. And amplifying the good is all about asking yourself, what has happened for me in the last few days that I can be especially grateful for? You know, as human beings, like 90% or more of our thoughts are recycled day in and day out. We're thinking about the same things all the time, and very rarely will we slow down and stop and think about the things that have happened for us in our life that we can be especially proud of or grateful for. So ask yourself, what is something that's happened for you recently in your life? Something that you've wanted to achieve, something that was difficult, but you did it anyway, that you can think about and you can get that good feeling to go through your body. And the way that I do these rituals is I'll write it down in my journal. I'll write it down such as, I am so happy and grateful for the big sale that I had a few days ago. And I'll literally close my eyes and I will literally re-see in my theater of imagination exactly what happened in that situation. I'll re-see, I'll visualize the good thing that happened for me that I can be grateful for. And I will relive the experience, because like I've mentioned in past videos, your brain doesn't know the difference between something that you're imagining and something that is real. And you can choose to relive these awesome, grateful experiences as often as you choose to. And this is actually a really good trick you can use if you want to change your emotional state throughout the day. If you're feeling down, if you're feeling sad, think of something that you can be absolutely and utterly grateful for and notice how quickly your mood changes. But I show you this one first because it's one of the most powerful strategies I'll use during my morning routine. So think about all the good things that are happening and truly be grateful for these awesome and great experiences. A second gratitude ritual that I'll practice is called gratitude stacking. And this is something that I got from a close friend of mine, Andrew Kapp, who's actually the author of a book called The Last Law of Attraction book that you'll ever need to read. And in the book, he talks about gratitude stacking in this way. If he's running short on time in the morning, if he's only got 5 or 10 minutes, he still gives time to his gratitude ritual. And what he does is he literally writes down in his journal, I am so grateful for, and he'll time himself for 5 minutes or 10 minutes or however long you want to do this. The longer you do this, the better that you'll feel. He literally writes down all of the different things that he can be grateful for in his life. Things that have happened in his life, things that might not have happened yet in his life. Some things he'll repeat because it just makes him feel that good. But think about it, how many different things can you be grateful for in your life right now? I am so happy and grateful for the fact that I have 2 arms and 2 legs. I'm grateful for my voice that allows me to talk to you and help you to create this gratitude ritual in your life. I'm so happy and grateful for this camera that allows me to broadcast this message literally across the world. I'm so happy and grateful for my health. I'm so happy and grateful for roads that allow me to get to where I need to go. As you can see, you can literally be writing for 50 minutes, an hour, 10 hours. If you really wanted to get crazy into this, you can find so many different things that you can be grateful for. And this is a great exercise to use if you're pressed on time. Another powerful gratitude exercise that I use is called gratitude achievement. And we've already talked about taking things that you've already achieved and being grateful for them and celebrating your wins as they happen. But something you can also do is imagine what it is you want. Imagine the things that you want to achieve in your life and visualize them during your gratitude ritual and be grateful for the things that haven't yet happened in your life. Because let's face the reality, these goals that you want to achieve, you're more than likely going to achieve them. It's just a matter of time of when you'll achieve them. So what would happen if you told your mind that you've already achieved these things that you don't yet have? As an example, if you want to attract the love of your life into your life, a part of your morning routine could be visualizing and feeling the emotion of gratitude for the person in your life that brings you this joy and brings you this love. And in your mind's eye, when you're seeing and visualizing this experience that you're so grateful for, you can literally see a picture of the person that you want to attract into your life. And you can be grateful that they're in your life now. And you might be thinking, Brandon, this sounds kind of crazy. How can I tell my brain to be grateful for something that I don't yet have? Like I mentioned, your brain doesn't know the difference between something you have and don't have. And if you tell your brain that you already have something that you don't yet have, it confuses your brain and it causes your brain to want to make things right. And the way that your brain makes it right is it helps you to attract that person, that place, or that thing into your life so that it is real. So visualize and be grateful for the things that you don't even have yet. Think of your end result. Think of the thing that you want to achieve, and then feel so much immense gratitude for that thing and watch it start to flow into your life effortlessly. But remember, when it comes to any of these exercises and any of these rituals, it's important to do them every single day. You have to stay consistent with it. And I had an interview recently with Andrew Kapp, who I mentioned earlier, and he goes deeper into these gratitude rituals. He goes deeper into the law of attraction and how you can activate it using gratitude. So I want you to watch this video right here, where we go deeper into those principles and insights so that you can incorporate this into your life and see real, lasting results. And until we talk again next time, continue to be better.